Well, right now, PG&E crews continue to struggle with getting the power back on for thousands of people in the foothills. They've been in the dark for 3 days now. KCRA3's David Bienick is live for us in Placerville with how one family is coping with no power. David.
Galston, good evening. Yes, despite all the equipment and people that PG&E has brought in, the utility estimates that it still has 12,000 homes and businesses in the dark tonight here in El Dorado County. Each of those is a family trying to find its own way to survive. Melinda Davies takes a scoopful of snow, puts it in a pan, and begins to melt it on top of her family's wood stove.
I'm melting snow to make water.
The water is to help flush the family's toilet and to feed their goats, including this little guy, born just today and likely to have a storm-related name.
Either Frozo or Snowfall.
After 3 days without power at their home on the outskirts of Placerville, the Davies are using a car battery to power their aquarium and keep their tropical fish alive. Today, thanks to some friends who brought by takeout, they had the closest thing they've seen to a real hot meal.
It's a, what is this? Angus?
Deluxe.
Melinda homeschools her two children, ages 11 and 12. Still, she says she's not used to having them around this much, especially with no television and no video games to keep them occupied.
It's nerve-wracking is the only word I can come up with.
But the Davies say there is an upside, because without the power outage, they might have missed the moment today when their new baby goat was born.
If the electricity was on, I wouldn't have seen the birth.
Why not?
Because the TV would probably be on or the computer.
And so, because of the good and the bad, the Davies family expects that they will remember this particular snowstorm
forever.
Memorable family moments that hopefully will soon be coming to an end. A late update from PG&E. There are now 9,000 customers without power in El Dorado County. They're estimating full restoration sometime tomorrow. Live in Placerville, David Bienick, KCRA 3 Report.